been a long recovery process.
Pam Bowman knows what it's like to be bullied.
It starts off as confusion because you're not sure whether or not what you're experiencing is real.
Pam says she spent about 15 years facing increasingly hostile treatment while working at a local vet clinic.
I'll never be the same. It is one of those life-changing experiences.
Now she's using her experience to help others. Pam is part of Powerless to Powerful, a conference geared at addressing workplace bullying and harassment. Many of the people here wanting to remain anonymous for fear it may bring about retaliation from coworkers.
In Canada and North America, workplace bullying does happen, and it does affect women and men. They are hearing some good information. They want to tell their story, but they also want to have some solutions or some takeaways.
It's estimated 1 in 3 people face some sort of mistreatment at work. With such high numbers and the effects on workers' health, some experts are calling workplace bullying an epidemic.
It's a split workforce. Half know about it and half either say they don't or pretend they don't.
Dr. Gary Namie has spent more than a decade touring North America, talking with employers and employees about how to create better working environments. He says we need to treat workplace bullying as a form of violence.
Since bullying has absolutely nothing to do with work, rather the bully's personal agenda that undermines work, undermines people, and basically undermines any government ministry's job, then it should be eliminated.
Saskatchewan is leading the country when it comes to anti-bullying legislation. In 2007, the government amended the definition of harassment in the Occupational Health and Safety Act to include workplace bullying, something few other provinces have done. It's a move that came too late for Pam, but one that also gives her hope in a future without workplace bullying.
We can make the world better. We can make our workplace a better place to work.
Danelle Boyven, Global News.